We're looking for bats. Mario, our mammalogist, has set up a couple of mist nets that kind of traverse the trail that we have here. So there are some running this way and some running crossways. So bats will fly around kind of familiar paths at night, and oftentimes they'll turn off their sonar if it's like a highway that they've navigated before. It's kind of like flying on autopilot. So we're hoping to catch some of them in some of these nets here, which will just stop them mid-flight, and then we can look at them and see what's flying around the area. Yeah? Under? Oh, that's big. What kind of bat is it?
Es un murciélago que se alimenta de insectos. Se llama Philostomus elongatus. Míralo.
Wow.
¿Ves cómo está de preñadita, no?
So Mario, what are you going to do with this?
Lo voy a tomar fotos y lo voy a liberar. Ah, este es una carolia. Carolia perspicillata. Es un murciélago que se alimenta de frutas. Pues más importante aún porque él actúa como un dispersador de semillas, que son plantas que crecen primero en un área que ha sido deforestada, ¿no?
So in the span of like 2 minutes, they caught 2 different kinds of species. In the same net, along the same line. One is an insect-eating bat, and then the other one was a fruit-eating bat. And what they're gonna do now is keep them in bags for a minute and then take them out, photograph them before they release them.
F***ing nuts, man. Love it.
I was sitting over at the lunch table earlier tonight, and I saw, and the sun was going down, and I just saw the leaf litter moving, and I jumped up and I said, what is that? And I thought it was either some kind of mammal or a snake. And we put a flashlight or a headlamp down a hole and saw this guy's rear end, and then have kind of been waiting all night for it to come out. And it is like the largest tarantula I have ever seen. And it's the largest tarantula that a lot of other people have ever seen here. We think it's a bird-eating tarantula, so the idea that a spider could kill and consume a bird is kind of unfathomable. And it's also been like kicking off its rear hairs all night, kind of in a defense. And I've been told that they have hallucinogenic properties, so I don't really know why I'm standing with my face so close to its butt. So Alvaro, the guy who caught this thing, captured it after he had gotten out of the bath wearing his towel. He only put clothes on.
I couldn't be so pretending.
He only put clothes on to
you
know,
put your hand and it's gonna go it.
Oh my gosh. This, he doesn't want to walk on me. It's, yeah, I don't know. If it starts cruising again, well, all right. Okay, I signed myself up for that. I cannot believe this thing.
Beautiful.
I let it get closer to her face.
Oh, screw you, Tom. Oh, man. Is it gonna comb my hair?
It still has brains on it.